By the way, you know what I thought was super disrespectful? Do you see the video of Floyd at the college football game?
Yeah, that was funny.
Tell everybody what happened, Pita.
This dude's walking by, he's like, hey, Floyd. Floyd turns like
he's a fan.
He's like, oh, fuck you up. And Floyd just like, what the fuck? Like,
what? That's not a con. He was with
so
his kids
like
and
that.
With his
dumb.
And then he walked away. It's not like he stood there.
It's funny because it's funny like knowing that you know that guy can't fuck with Floyd Mayweather. That's why it's funny.
But very
he's just
disrespectful.
An idiot. Like,
I didn't think that was cool. Yeah. There's a time and a place, not when he's with his kids. And
it's funny.
And don't run away.
I thought it was hilarious.
I don't know. I have to ask your dad and Emmett as well in 13 seconds.
I thought it was hilarious. Because you know.
It's disrespectful.
Because you know he can't. Like, that's why it's funny. Because you know he knows he can't either. Like,
but
he
it's
knows he can't fuck up Floyd. Yeah, it's stupid. But I thought it was funny.
Robert, did you see the video?
What video?
You saw it, Jose, right?
Oh, the guy that walks by Floyd Mayweather?
Floyd's in a football game.
Floyd? Like professional NFL?
No, college, championship. Oh, college. And some guy walks by and says, Floyd. Floyd thinks he can tell him a cop. He's like, I'm going to F you up.
I'll fuck you up.
And yeah. Floyd looks at him like, what?
Just a fan?
Yeah, but that was just, he's with his kids. He's with his...
I'm sure it's not the first time that something like that happens
the
to
the first time on camera. But the guy ran away. He didn't stick around for the fireworks.
Yeah.
Did you see it, Jose?
No. I didn't see
that. That never happens to you, right?
It's funny.
By the way, Regis was talking a lot of smack about Jose.
Was he?
Yeah, I don't know
it's
why.
Right.
Jose answered him yesterday.
Jose's got a fight coming up. Regis, we still don't know who he's going to fight or defend his title against. You know, it was just... He also said it when I think you had him...
On the live,
he
yeah.
He said, it's business, so exactly. He wouldn't say, okay, I want to fight so much, let's do 50-50. He didn't say that either. So,
well, Jose even said 60-40, right?
Exactly.
He didn't, 45, 50,
so he didn't say, let's do it. So it's business.
By the way, ESPN just announced Jose Ramirez against Richard Comey. Richard Comey, southpaw, right?
Yeah.
Hits hard, dude puncher.
Yes. We have Jose, Raymond Murataya on that card. And then we have Javier Martinez and the Giant, Antonio Mireles.
What are the chances of seeing Ray against Devin Haney?
Ray who? Oh, Raymond Murataya? Just
July?
No,
December?
Haney's fighting,
Loma.
Loma.
But what is?
But they're fighting sometime in May or June.
Okay.
So it would have to be after that. But I think Haney might move up in weight.
You think so?
I think so. After he beats Loma, if he beats Loma, he might just vacate and move up in weight.
It's a 50-50
fight. I'm thinking.
Shakur wants the winner.
Shakur will get up. Well, whoever wins, it's actually makes sense to wait and fight Shakur because it'll
big money.
It's
fight.
A huge fucking fight too. But I don't know. I really don't know. I have a feeling after that fight, if Haney wins, I think Baker's the top. So. Raymond, by then, I think he should be in a good position to be ranked in the top. You know, I'll fight him against anybody. I want 135 after that.
He's super talented.
Shit. You know, there's so many guys that obviously we can't even say we're going after this guy because they're with other promoters, you know. But I wouldn't mind him fighting somebody like Rollies or Camarón Cepeda, Pitbull Cruz.
Nobody wants to fight Pitbull.
But exactly, but I wouldn't mind. But they're with different promotions, so more likely that wouldn't even happen. More likely that wouldn't even happen. So, you know, so we're not cutting those guys out because it's just not going to happen. But I wouldn't mind fighting him against those type of guys.
He's a future superstar.
Yeah, I've said it before. Right now, if they have to fight Kambosos, I'll take the fight right away.
He beats Kambosos with one hand tied behind his back.
I think I'll fight Kambosos without a problem right now, right away.
But that's not a real test.
No, Bob. Kambosos was undisputed. What the fuck?
Oh, sorry. He's the best fighter in the history of the world. He's at my Mount Rushmore. What did he say?
He was undisputed. So you got to respect that, Daddy.
How long did he last?
Undisputed? So what? It doesn't matter how long it lasts.
Robert,
undisputed.
If your clock breaks, it's right twice a day.
None of the undisputed champs last being undisputed for very long.
They don't.
Josh Taylor fought Jose, and right after the fight, you had to get rid of all, start getting rid of all the belts, because then sanctioning fees and mandatories and a bunch of shit. Nobody really lasts. Yeah,
that's not Usyk, the reason Usyk. he lost to Haney because Haney kicked his ass.
Oh yeah, yeah, but I'm saying nobody lasts as undisputed champ, so you can't go there.
Yeah, nobody stays.
Yeah, nobody does.
Who's gonna beat Jermell Charlo?
No, but the thing is, he's gonna have to get rid of everything, and he's not the undisputed champion anymore. Okay.
All I know is Kambosos is not the best fighter ever.
No, but without him, man, he could stay undisputed for 2 years, not even fight, and still be undisputed. Can you repeat that? With PBC, he could be undisputed for 2 years and not even fight once and still be undisputed.
Okay, serious question.
Yeah.
In the history of undisputed champs, is Kambosos the best undisputed or the worst undisputed?
I would have to go to see who the other ones were, but not one of the best.
He's not Mike Tyson, he's not Lennox Lewis, he's not Canelo, he's not Zab Judah, he's not any of these legends.
He's not one of the best. I don't know if Zab Judah was undisputed. Was he?
47.
Zab Judah?
No.
Yeah. Zab Judah was undisputed.
Oh shit, I didn't know that. I don't think so. Wow, doesn't matter.
Shout out to Zab. Hey, you know Zab has his own line of condoms now, by the way?
Who?
Zab.
You know what?
I think he needs to sponsor some of his fighters. Protect yourself at all times.
You know what, right now, the way the kids are growing up and everything, they're being more careful. You don't see a lot of young girls pregnant anymore.
Not like
in the 90s, early 2000s, shit, you know, it was different. Right now, like, kids are thinking, girls are also being a little more careful.
That's good.
It's good.